As an organologist, musicologist, and organist, Armando Caradeo has done much to inform our understanding of historic Italian organs and early keyboard repertories. Of particular importance, he is the director of Tastature, a series of critical editions of early keyboard music, and I can't emphasize enough how he has unlocked much of this history through his work with this series. He has edited more than 30 volumes in this series, including the first critical edition of the keyboard works of Bernardo Pasquini. And as I mentioned earlier, he is currently working on a new edition of the complete keyboard works of Girolamo Frescobaldi. Professor Caradeo speaks to us this afternoon on the topic of the Jesuits and the Roman organ tradition. Please welcome Armando Caradeo.
The presence of the Society of Jesus in the history of culture in the last five centuries was prodigious, not only in theological and philosophical sciences, but also through its universities in all fields of science, in the construction of the numerous churches connected to its institutions. It promoted the realization of masterpieces in all the arts, architecture, sculpture, painting, and so forth. Since the organ was an important element of the liturgical apparatus, the society provided its churches with instruments of the highest quality in accordance with the style of each nation. It's interesting to note that since the pursuit and development of culture was one of the objectives expressed by the founder Ignazio di Loyola, the creation of the works of art were not only commissioned to the finest artists of the period, but were also created by members of the society belonging to the category fratres coadjutores, members who were not ordained priests, but whose function was to provide a service to the community according to their capacity, ranging from the most humble tasks to the high arts, including architecture, sculpture, painting, etc., and also organ building. In Italy, for example, there is the painter and architect Andrea Pozzo, the painter of the extraordinary perspective of the ceiling of the Sant'Ignazio in Rome, and also of the finest portrait of Bernardo Pasquini, for instance. And more pertinent to our discussion, the excellent organ builder Wilhelm Hermanns, 1601-1683, among the most famous of the 17th century, of Flemish origins and active first in the Flanders and France, and then in Italy from 1648 till his death. I will only have time in this conference to speak of some of the influences of the Society of Jesus upon the development of the history of organ building in Italy between the 16th century and the beginning of the 20th. Starting from the archive documents that I have discovered in the Archivium Historicum Societatis Jesu, kept in Rome, kept at the headquarters of the Society of Jesus. Similar narratives can be, however, constructed in all those nations where the Jesuits based themselves and were active, in Europe and in other continents, in particular in South America. Chapter 1, Italy. The Society of Jesus, founded in 1540, spread quickly thanks to an extraordinary organizational efficiency. The German College, Collegium Germanicum, was founded in 1552 next to the Church of Sant'Apollinare in Rome near Piazza Navona, 12 years after the foundation of the Society, and it served as the prototype for the seminaries in which the Council of Trent decreed that clerics should be given their intellectual and spiritual formation. Musical education was of a high level, since influential musicians such as Tommaso da Vittoria, Agostino Agazzari, Ruggero Giovannelli, Francesco Antonio Anerio, and later Giacomo Carissimi and Giuseppe Ottavio Bitoni worked there as maestri di cappella. The importance of this educational center was the fact that the students at the end of their study period returned to their German-speaking countries of origin and were able to spread the excellence of the education they had received, including that in music. Thus, it became a point of confluence between North and South, enabling each region to be exposed to the style of the others. The first three organs in the church on Santa Apollinare that we know of are of the highest standard of excellence. The first mention of an organ in Santa Apollinare is one of 1576. Four scudi were given to the organist, who ought to adjust the organ by raising the pitch, as I found in the archive. But there is no trace of the structure of the instrument nor of its builder. On April 15, 1581, the rector of the college commissioned the construction of a new organ for the church to be built by Sebastian High, organist at the Holy House of Loreto, with 15 registers, trombones, flutes, nightingales, with tremolo, timpani, or drums, and two keyboards in the Flemish manner. The organ should be appropriately played on the vigil of the feast on Santa Apollinare in the month of July 1582. In reality, the organ was played for the first time on March 25, 1583, the feast of the Annunciation. On April 12, 1583, 472 scudi are given to the Maestro Bastian High, organist, for the building of the organ, including the 100 scudi in gold, which are added for the three registers made over and above the first contract. So the document. Some years later, we don't know exactly when, it was modified. The small organ has not been altered at all from what it was before. On the great organ, the low octave was added only to the principale and the octave. The keyboard of the great organ, which previously had 45 keys, now has 50 keys. The trombones are in unison with the octave of the great organ. Here is the disposition of this instrument. And you can see that the fundamental registers, stops, are of Italian style, plus some registers in Flemish style. The influence of this important instrument on organ building in Rome is demonstrated by the contract signed on the 16th December 1583 by Francesco Palmieri on the addition of the positive organ, as in Santa Apollinare, to the Domenico Benvenuti organ in the Church of Araceli in Rome. In all likelihood, it also influenced the excellent organ builder Luca Biagi from Umbria. It is not certain whether the great organ in the transept of the Basilica of San Giovanni in Laterano, built for the Jubilee year of 1600, had two keyboards from the very beginning. But in 1999, while I was making an inventory and description of the 10 organs in Sulmona and Tescano in Abruzzo, a friend who works in the archives referred me to a contract by Luca Biagi in 1602 for an organ to be installed in the famous Basilica dell'Annunziata in Sulmona. The project contemplated the construction of a single keyboard organ for a certain price and a double keyboard instrument for a higher price. The signed contract registers the higher price and therefore indicates that the double keyboard organ were built. The layout of the stops, however, were completely in line with the Italian tradition, without influence from Flemish tradition. The second keyboard only had stops from the Principale family. Built at the beginning of the 17th century, the Church of Jesus in Rome had three organs installed in the course of the century. At present, however, the precise history can't be reconstructed. In recent research at the Historic Archives of the Society in Rome, I found an important document referring to the restoration of the old organ in the chapel of Sant'Ignazio. It's the transcription in pen on a slip of paper of a label stuck on the inside of the wind chest that contains important information. The Cavalier Ennio Bonifazi da Cerreto Umbria made it in 1623. The Cavalier Attilio Priori restored it in 1865. It probably referred to the first organ built for the Jesus Church, Ennio Bonifazi, together with the Benvenutis and Giovanni Guglielmi, were the highest exponents in Rome of the art of organ builder in that time. From my previous studies in the historic archives of the Jesuits in Rome, I had found a recept for the gilding of the organ in 1634 and a recept for the painting for the two organs. Hence, in 1634, the second organ was finished and was installed probably in the chapel of San Francesco di Sales in front of the chapel of Sant'Ignazio. These are the two organs that Willem Hermans worked on over a period of time and who also constructed his own organ for the Church of Jesus. Perhaps for the choir, that whose case is now above the entrance door. In the notices from the first half of the 19th century, the tradition of the concert of the three organs is described taking place at evening on San Silvestro at 10:30 p.m., in which the two organs of the chapels of Sant'Ignazio and San Francesco di Sales and the organ on the cornicione, on the main door, above the entrance door. Yeah. Chapter 2, Willem Hermans. In the second half of the 17th century, Willem Hermans dominated the panorama of organ builders in Italy. Born in 1601 at Thorn in the Diocese of Liège, he entered the Society of Jesus on October 4, 1631 at Malines and spent the succeeding years working on organs in French and Belgian churches. By 1648, he had arrived in Italy, where he remained until his death, 1683. The list of organs built by Willem Hermans in Italy, described by Renato Lunelli and Thomas Scali, is incomplete. There were only the Duomo of Como, Basilica of Santa Maria in Carignano in Genova, Santa Apollinare and Sant'Agnese in Rome, Church of the Santo Spirito in Pistoia. And that was all. Here you have the disposition of the great organ in the dome in the Cathedral of Como. The great organ, as is clear, has the whole family of the principal register. And here links, you see the other registers, the tromboni and tromba, and the flauto sesquialtera with cornetto. They were registers under the influence of Flemish style. Flemish style is also more the organo piccolo, the second keyboard. The organ in Santa Apollinare by Sebastian Hai has the same characteristic. The principal family as in Italian tradition, plus some registers of the Flemish family. What's very interesting is now, this was what Father Calley found in the archive of the Jesuits, an autograph of by Wilhelm Hermanns that describes the various possibility to combine the registers. As you see, ripieno with all the registers of the principal family, with the addition, one can add the sesquialtra or the tromba basso to the plenum. Then registrations with three or four registers. Then registration with two registers, and at the end of one register. And you see, for example, in this position, in the registration with one register, also the quinta decima alone. The organ in the Cathedral of Como made a great impression because of the novelty of the timbers in an Italian context, and greatly influenced organ building in Lombardy and elsewhere. Before my research, it was not known that in Como, Wilhelm Hermanns not only constructed the great organ of the cathedral, but also, since he was a guest at the residence of the society attached to the Church of Jesus, the superior implored the superior general to allow Brother William to remain a father 4 months in order to construct a small organ for their church. The superior general gave his permission, the organ was replaced in the 19th century, and the pipes of the Hermanns organ were seen in a box kept at the house of the Figlia della Carità, Vincentia's order, from Mendrisio in Swiss, by a Vincentian father from the congregation of the mission, who took over from the Jesuits after the suppression of the society at the end of the 18th century. I couldn't see these pipes until now. On the occasion of the restoration of the first of the two surviving Hermanns organs, Pistoia and Collecipoli, I was engaged by the restorer Riccardo Lorenzini to research the subject at the General Archives of the Society of Jesus in Rome. At the beginning of the investigation, it was immediately clear that Wilhelm Hermanns was not tied to any particular residence connected to the society, but dependent directly upon the superior general, to whom came the requests for the construction and maintenance of the organs, both in the Jesuit residence in all the Italian provinces and external committees. I decided, therefore, to read all the copies of the Superior General's letter that enabled me to reconstruct with precision and completeness all of Hermanns' movements in the 35 years of his activity in Italy. A similar study was carried out by the Jesuit archivist Father Pirri, whose dossier was made available to me. I was hence able to verify and correct Pirri's transcriptions and greatly amplify the quantity of information that escaped his research. Here is the list. And the novelty are Como, the second organ of the Church of Jesus, the organ in Turin, and in the second organ in Palermo and in Perugia, and Ascoli, and so on. More information could still emerge from the state archives in Rome, as seen to a certain extent in the articles published by Patrizio Barbieri and other articles that come. So, third chapter, 19th century. The first organ by the Serassi brothers in Rome. During my research on Wille Mermans in the Rome archives of the Society, on the occasion of the cited restorations, I came across an important fascicle containing a vast documentation of the installation of the first Serassi organ in Rome. It was commissioned, thanks to the initiative of the rector of the Collegio Romano, by the Father General of the Society, initially for the Church of Sant'Ignazio, but later in reality installed in the Church of Jesus. The importance of this discovery demanded an immediate study and publication of the abundant archival material, since it concerned one of the largest organs by one of the most important organ builders operating in Italy between the 18th and the 19th centuries. Unfortunately, we don't know if any of the pipes remain today. With Oscar Mischiati, to whom I had shown the discovered documents, we had made the proposal a few years before his death, to search for any phonic material from the Serassi organ in the three cases that today contain the modern Tamburini organ, 1929, an instrument that has three keyboards with electric transmission. In the long and glorious history of Serassi art of organ building, the satisfaction of building one of the organs in the center of Christianity was missing. And when finally the occasion presented itself, the adventure was long and tormented as if from a novel, as is described by the abundance of details in the archive documents. The project with the contract proposal was presented in November 1828. The installment of the organ in the Church of Sant'Ignazio presented, however, considerable difficulties. The project of the organ described two keyboards, that of the great organ with 57 keys, with a short octave, and that of the echo organ with 49 keys, with no pipes for the short octave, in unison with the second C of the 8-foot principal of the great organ. The first project contained the surprising split bassi soprani between the F-sharp and G, since it was normally not employed by Serassi. The usual split was between B and C, but here, as usual, Serassi accommodated the client's special requests. The split for this first project for Sant'Ignazio can be compared to the organ by the Jesuit Wille Mermans in the Church of the Holy Spirit in Pistoia. Hermans himself placed the split instead between the E and F in the late organ at Colle Scivoli. In the modifications to the project for the new destination of the Church of Jesus, Serassi lowers the split of D sharp. To make the new organ similar to another already existing organ, perhaps the Hermann's organ. On 9 November 1828, with the approval of the Father General, the project was accepted despite strong opposition. The reasons for the objections are not clear from the documents, though they are evident already from the beginning of the negotiations. The most likely reason was the elevated cost of the project. Some of the Brotherhood would have preferred to have collocated that amount for other expenses in the Church of Sant'Ignazio, in order to avoid grumbling from the congregation. The objections were so strong that the annulment of the contract with Serassi was taken into consideration. The Father General wished that the organ was not to be installed in the Church of Sant'Ignazio, but rather in the Church of Jesus in the gallery in front of the San Francesco Saverio Chapel. The organ reached Rome in June 1831 and allocated in 1 year later. The specifications you see there, the organ is very great, and also the second keyboard is very large. We can conclude. You can see here some instruments of Hermann's. Genova, we have only the case without pipes, and then Colle Scipoli, Pistoia, and under the Colle Scipoli. The two instruments that were restored by Riccardo Lorenzini for 50 years. 15 years, sorry. Conclusion. These three brief essays on the 16th, 17th, and 19th centuries demonstrate a constant attention by the Society of Jesus toward the elevated quality of the organs built for their churches. Instead, in the 20th century, bad taste prevailed in the construction of all-round instruments with a large number of stops originating from diverse organ-building traditions. The employment of new industrial technologies, including electrical transmission, sacrificing the individuality of the single instrument. The adoption of generically industrial pipe intonation and pneumatic or electrical transmission that does not allow the player any control over the variety and sensitivity of touch and articulation. Fortunately, after the Second World War, interest was reborn in instruments with a precise personality, mechanical transmission, with special care taken in the quality of the voicing of each single pipe and the harmonization of the stops. With the rebirth of organ builders, true sound artists. Historic organs are no longer substituted and destroyed, but rather restored according to the carefully studied guidelines in the conservation of these musical treasures from various past periods. Thank you.
We have time for questions and comments. Eduardo.
One question is, if you can explain two things. One is, what is the voce puerile in the list of the stops?
Yes. It's voce umana is not voce umana, but reed stop.
It's voce umana, the voce umana.
Yes, 8 foot.
What do you do with the voce umana here?
Voce umana is a reed stop 8 foot. And voce puerile is a reed stop 4 foot.
And the other little thing was about the specification of the Serassi organ, that is 1828. But Serassi started already to build this kind of instrument 30 years before, for example, in Colorno, in Parma. Yes. And this is more for the student, it's surprising when you look at the list of the ripieno. Because here the ripieno arrived to the vigesima nona, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 octave higher. But there you have the trigesima terza, another fifth higher, trigesima sesta, another octave higher, quadragesima, another fifth and quadragesima sesta. So it's a huge amount of ranks working together, but you can use also separately. This is very interesting how Serassi developed this concept of the Italian ripieno in the time.
Other questions, comments? If not, let's thank Armando Caradeo for being here and giving us this paper.